Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us continue with the next topic. Okay, so the topic is asymptotic notations, guys. So if you ask me, in the whole subject of algorithms, so which is the most important thing to understand is nothing but the asymptotic notations, guys. So asymptotic notations are abstract notations for describing the behavior of an algorithm and determine the rate of growth of a function. Okay, yes. So as we are going through the types of asymptotic notations, you will get a clear idea, guys. So don't get scared with respect to it. Okay, yes. So let me take a piece of paper first of all, so that we can start our discussion, guys. Okay, just give me a second. Sorry for that. Okay, yes. So let us start. So basically, before going through the terminologies and all those complex things, so let us understand some basic things first of all, guys. Okay, yes. So the first thing is with respect to a graph, okay, so assume that this is your input size and this is the time. Okay, so assume that you wrote a block of a code or you designed an algorithm, guys. So it is taking based on input, okay, so it is going in this way. Okay, so this is your function which you wrote f of n, and you wrote an algorithm, so that algorithm is working in this way. So based on the input size increase, it will also increasing in time also. Okay, yes. Okay, so once you have an idea like how the function is acting, okay, so you will compare it with, guys. So assume that n, so where n it will be there, guys. So it will be somewhere like this, right? Yes, like exact n value. Okay, so where n square will be there, so it will increase slowly or fast, it will increase rapidly, right? Yes, so it assume that it is in that way. Okay, yes. So they might be a bit curved also, guys. So for our easy understanding, I'm drawing with respect to straight lines. Okay, yes. So where will log n be, guys? So log n, sorry, log, right? So log n will always be less than n, right? So that is the reason why I assume that it is somewhere down here. Okay, yes. So this is a log n. Okay, so now you got some understanding, right? So basically, if you observe carefully, this is our f of n function, right? Yes. So with respect to this, which is near, we should compare and we should give some notations, right? Yes. So the first type of notation is big O, guys. Okay. So big O notation states that what is the maximum bound or upper bound, it simply says, guys. So once you remember the upper, once you recall upper bound, so what is upper bound case, guys? It is nothing but worst case. So big O of something will say the worst case, guys. Got it? Yes. So what is f of n above it, guys? So basically, what is the worst case with respect to f of n? At max, how much it can be? It can be n square, right? Yes. So it is indirectly for f of n is less than big O of n square. This is correct, right? So basically, what does a big O say? So it will say the worst case. Means this is a maximum it is saying. So n square is greater than f of n is what it is saying. So that is true, right?
Yes.
So this is a big O notation. So you will be checking the above cases. Okay. Similarly, the second type is omega, guys. Okay. So omega will be represented in this way. Okay. So omega is a lower bound, guys. Means it will say the best case. Got it?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry. It will say the best case. So what is the best case here, guys? So it is below it, right?
Yes.
So at minimum, it might be till here, right? Okay.
Okay, so just give me a second. Okay, yes.
Okay, yes. So lower bound means it will say the minimum value, right? Yes. So what is the minimum value of f of n? So at some point, it is close to this, right? So assume that it is in this way, okay?
Yes.
So at that time, this is close to this one, right?
Yes.
So it will say the minimum value. So basically, it will be in this way. So anyway, I'll be going through the equation. So don't get scared why I'm writing in that way, okay?
Yes.
So here we are saying this n is a minimum than this. Okay, so big O indicates a maximum. Okay, omega indicates minimum. Okay, so what is the average case then? Theta will be the average case. So which says that exact value, guys. So what is the exact value? So assume that is n log n, just for our assumption. So I think n log n will also be less than n. Okay, so anyway, assume that is x. So that will be in this way. Got it? So that is theta. So basically, big O indicates the maximum value inside it. Omega indicates the minimum value inside it. Theta indicates the equal value inside it. Got it?
Yes.
So now let us go through some terminology. So now you got an idea, right? So basically, what is a big O? So big O says a maximum time. So basically, if this is taking this much time, you are saying this much time. So it is maximum time. Similarly, omega is saying minimum time. And theta is saying the average time. So basically it will be approximately long with it, right?
Yes, got it. You got the idea, right? So how I'm trying to explain you. Okay, so now let us go to this terminology. So now you'll be getting more clear idea. Okay,
yes. So big O notation, that is nothing but the big O notation defines an upper bound. I told you, right? So it will say the maximum value,
okay, of an algorithm. Okay, so of an algorithm. Okay,
so the big O notation is used when we have upper bound on time complexity of an algorithm. So whenever you want to calculate the upper bound or the maximum time the algorithm might take, we'll be using this big O notation. Okay,
so many times we easily find the upper bound by simply looking at the algorithm.
Okay,
yes. So it will look in this way, guys. So f of n and c into g of n is nothing but your value, which is above f of n, right? So it is above f of n, right?
Yes.
So that is nothing but here you can say it as big O of g of n is equal to f of n. So in this way you can represent. So this is the representation, guys. So few of you might be saying that how did I represent in that way? So this is the basic formula or function, you can say. So f of n equal to big O of g of n. So when you can say this formula is true, if and only if there exists a positive constant C, okay, and n naught, okay, at some point, such that f of n, okay, is less than, okay, or equal to C into G of n. So basically C into G of n should be greater. Okay, so that's what we want, guys. So if it is C into G of n is greater, then you can say that big O of n. So you can represent it in this way. So C into G of n. So from this understanding, what you understood, guys? So if we are having a big O, so big O indicates maximum. So what is inside this, that is only maximum.
Okay, got it? Yes. So that's a simple logic which you can remember, guys, because in future we might sometimes get confused. So that's the reason I'm saying. So big O, so inside brackets what you wrote, that is the property of it. So it is nothing but maximum than this. Got it?
Yes.
So basically you might be saying that what is this n naught?
Okay, so in simple words, n naught is nothing but at some point, okay, so before that point, the properties of them. So basically what is this C into G of n, guys? So this is a C into G of n, right?
Yes.
And this is F of n. So initially C into G of n is less than F of n, right? But after some time, so basically with respect to time, after some particular point, always F of n is below C into G of n, right? So it's shuffled. So this point at after which it is constant. So basically even if you take at n equal to 1 million, these two will be in this order only. So basically C into G of n will be above and F of n will be below. So that kind of a point is nothing but n naught, guys. Got it?
Yes.
So at that point, from that point, always F of n is below and C into G of n is above. So that point is nothing but n naught. Okay, where n is greater than or equal to n naught. Got it?
Yes.
So now you got a clear idea with respect to big O, right?
Yes.
So big O means whoever is having a big O, they are maximum. Got it?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So now let us take a small example, guys. Okay.
Yes.
So here they give f of n equal to 8n square plus 3n plus 70. Okay. So now if you write the complexity for this, what will be, guys? So it is a nothing but n square, right? So if you recall, I told you. In this lecture or in the previous lecture, I told you. So if we are having various additions, so among these three parts, which is maximum? So this is maximum. So you can avoid these two, guys. So there is no need of them to represent. Okay. And similarly, this 8 is also constant. So what we are left out with n square. So n square will be your complexity. Okay.
Yes.
So now in the question only, they give four options. So g1 of n equal to 4, g2 of n equal to 3, g3 of n equal to n square, g4 of n equal to n. Okay, so n power 4, n power 3, n square and n. Okay, so now they are asking whether f of n is equal to big O of g of n. So what is our thing, guys? So whoever is having a big O means a maximum. So this value should be maximum. Okay, so we know what is f of n. So f of n is nothing but n square, right? So after simplifying this, it is n square. So this side we are having n square. So now let us compare. So what is a g of 1? That is nothing but n power 4. Yes, n power 4 is a bigger, right?
Yes.
So hence this is true. Similarly with respect to g2. So is n cube greater than n square, guys?
Yes.
Similarly, is n square greater than or equal to? So if you recall, we are having equal to also. Right?
Yes.
So that is the reason why n square is greater than or equal to n square.
Yes, that is also true.
Coming to the last case, n is greater than n square. So this is false. So in this way, you can analyze, guys. Guys, we'll be taking multiple examples and multiple previous year question papers. So anyway, you'll get a clear idea in future, guys. Okay. So now you just need some basic understanding. That's it. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, so now I think everyone is 100% clear with Big O notation, right? Yes. So one of the most important notation is also Big O, guys. Okay. Yes. So now let us go to the next notation. Sorry, next notation. That is omega. So omega notation is helpful for designing or describing the lower bound, guys. So if you recall, I told for this, right? So if this is our function, so below it we are having f, n, right? Yes. So always f of n is above n, right? Yes. So that is what we will represent, guys. So here we are discussing about a lower bound, right? So minimum value. So the equation will be the function f of n is equals to omega of g of n if and only if there exists a positive constant c comma n naught such that f of n is greater than. So basically our function should be above and this c into g of n should be below. Got it? Yes. For all n and n greater than or equal to 0. Sorry, greater than n naught. Got it? So now if you observe after a particular point, c into g of n is below and f of n is above. Got it? So what exactly it is? It is nothing but f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n. So this equation is for omega. Got it? Yes. Okay. Similarly for theta. So what exactly is theta, guys? So it should be an accurate value, right? Yes. So it should be almost near to our f of n, right? Yes. So means indirectly, it should be in between both of them, right? So if this is our worst case and this is our best case, average case where it will be there, guys, it will be in between, right? Yes. So that is nothing but our theta, guys. So it is nothing but average case or in middle or exact or closest. Got it? Yes. So for this, the function will be the function f of n is equals to theta of g of n if and only if there exists a positive constant c1, c2 and n0. So basically here we are having two things such that c1 into g of n is less than or equal to f of n, less than or equal to c2 into g of n for all n and n greater than n naught. Got it? Yes. So after this point, c1 into g of n is always below and c2 into g of n is always above. So basically here, if you avoid this part, so what is that case, guys? So that is nothing but lower bound, right? So if you avoid this, upper bound. So combination of both is nothing but theta. Got it? You got a clear idea, right? Yes. So now let us go through some more notations. So basically these are the three important notations, you can say. So along with these three, we are having additional two also. So those are nothing but small notations, guys. So the simple difference between the small notation is we are not going to have the equal to part. Okay, so if you recall, in big O and omega, we are having this equal to also, right? So it is a less than or equal to. So if it is a strictly less than, it is a nothing but a small notations, guys. Got it? Yes. So it's the same idea for omega also. Okay? Yes. Okay? So only strictly conditions. Okay? Yes. Those are small notations. Okay. So now your question will be, okay, so now we got some idea, but what type of questions can we expect in the examination, right? Yes. So few of you might be asking. So let us go through the first example. We'll be taking two examples, guys, and the rest examples we'll be discussing in our PYQPs. Okay. Yes. So let us start. So the first question is, maintain these things in the ascending, increasing order. Okay. Yes. So here he gave some functions, guys. So the thing is, we should analyze them and we should understand which is greater than which, guys. So that is our goal here. Okay. So let me note the question down. So f1 of n is equals to n power 0.099 log n. Okay. Similarly, f2 of n equal to 2, 3, 4, 5 n. And f3 of n equal to 1.00001 power n. Okay, so this is in there and this is in power. Okay, similarly f4 of n equal to n square. Okay, yes. So now you will be thinking that, okay, so how exactly we can solve or how exactly we can identify which is maximum and which is minimum. So there are some small tricks, guys, you can say. Okay, yes. So firstly, I'll be explaining you those tricks so that you can understand them easily. Okay, yes. So what is the minimum thing, guys? So in the constants, I'm saying, okay, yes. So the minimum value will be log n, guys. Okay. So log n is less than n. Okay. Yes. Similarly, n is less than n square. Okay. And n square is less than n factorial. Okay. So in this way, the flow will continue. Got it? Yes. So log n is always less than n. N is always less than n square. N square is always less than n factorial. In long run, I'm saying.
I'm not saying with the small values, with the large values. Okay.
Yes.
So now let us understand the options, guys. Okay. So from options, can you say anything 100% sure, guys? So one thing you can say. Okay. So the first thing which you can say is this value will always be less than the second value, right? So just observe carefully. So just the concentration is important here, guys. So I think I did not have calci. So just give me a second. I'll be bringing the calci. Okay. So I've just bought the calci, guys. Okay. So whenever you are practicing these kind of problems, please use our calculator, guys. So whenever you type in Google, directly type gate calculator, you will be getting from TCS. In TCS website, you can find, guys. Just type the word gate calculator, online calculator, you will be getting the first website with respect to TCS. So that's the calculator which we'll be using in gate also. Okay. Yes. So you can practice in that. So for now, I'll be using the normal calculator, guys. Okay. Yes. So the thing that you should remember is, so always log n value will be less, guys. So assume that I will be applying a log base 2. So let us take base 2 or base 10. So let us take direct log. Okay. So assume that I'm applying for 10. What will be the result, guys? The result will be something like 2.30. So it is always less. So any value you take, log 5000. So 8 points. So how much? It is 5000 and we got 8 point, guys. So it is reduced a lot, guys. I think, can you see it? So now you can see it, right? Sorry for that. Okay. Yes. So it is 8 points. So in that way, always a log value will be less, guys, with respect to n. Okay. So I think I need to turn on flashlight or something. So just give me a second. Okay. So now you can see, right? Yes. So now it's a bit clear, right? Yes. Okay. So in this way, so always a log value will be less. Similarly, if you are doing n and n square, so I think there's no need of checking these things, right? Yes. So now you can understand. So now based on our question, so what are the things in our question, guys? So by observation, most of us will be thinking that n square will be the maximum, right? But there is a small twist here. Okay. So we are checking in long runs, right? So what is 1.000001 whole power n and n square? So which is a maximum is the question, right? Yes. So if you observe carefully, whenever these kind of questions are there, so at some point this n value will be too high, right? So I think these type of questions cannot be solved directly in our calculator. So anyway, let me try 3 whole power. So let me write 10 power 10, guys. Okay. So for our easy understanding, let me write 10 power 10 if it is possible. 10 power 10. Okay. So 10 power 10. Okay. It is possible, luckily. Okay. Sorry. My bad. So I did not keep that last one, because that one is only important, right? Okay. So it's giving mathematical error. So let me at least write it 5. Okay. So now we got 1.105, right? Yes. So if you try that same thing for 10 power 5 whole square, right? Yes. Whole power 2. So it is nothing but 10 cross 25. So with this understanding, you will be saying that this will be maximum, right? But it is wrong, guys. So at some particular moment of time, this will cross this, guys. So basically, if this n square is in this way, I don't know how exactly we should draw n square and all those things. Okay. So if it is in that way, yet some, this value will be really low. It will be with respect to one only, but slowly it will increase, guys. At some point it will increase and it will cross this, because the only reason why I'm confidently saying is this value of n is always squared here, but it is whole power n, right? So remember that. So if we are having a n square, okay, and on the other side we are having some value whole power n, always this value will be having higher value at some point. I'm not saying at where, but at some point. Got it? Yes. So with this understanding, most of you will be saying that now f3 is the maximum, right? Yes. So f3 is maximum. So now let us understand which is minimum. So we need to arrange in ascending order, right? Okay. Yes. So now you got an idea, right? So basically at the end we will be having f3, and before that only we will have this n square, right? Because those both will have a common fight. Okay. Yes. So now let us check whether f2 is greater or f1 is greater. Okay. Yes. So if you observe carefully, so whenever you are multiplying something with a log, guys, so assume that n, what value shall let us take? So let us take 100. Okay. Yes. So 100 power 0.99, right? Yes. So it is going to reduce. So this is reducing the value. And if you multiply this with log 100 I took, right? So sorry, 1000 I took, right? Yes. Okay. So this will increase the value, right? Yes. Okay. So what I took? 1000. Okay. Similarly, let us take the second option. So 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3 into 1000. So this is greater value, right? So by this kind of understanding, you can say that F1 is the minimum value, right? And F2 is the next minimum, right? Yes. So this is the ascending order. So in this way, so based on some observations, you can draw, guys. So if you are a bit understand, if you are having good understanding with this, so by observing the question only, you will say this is the minimum value and this is the max. Sorry, this is the maximum value. So after that, you can compare with calculator or something. You can identify and you can specify which is maximum. So at the end, you will be getting the ascending order in this way, right? Yes. So now let us go through one more question. Okay. Yes. Okay, so now let us go to the last question with this topic. Okay, so then we'll be ending the lecture. Okay, so this question is, consider the following function. So they gave three functions and they gave four options. So basically with respect to big O notation, they gave the options. Okay, so now the first step which you should do is, you should identify which is the maximum order. So from minimum to maximum, let us try to identify this. So just give me a second, I will take my piece of paper. Okay, so now again, let us observe. So here we are having the first function as 3n root n. The second function is 2 power root n log base 2 n. And the third one is n factorial. Okay. Yes. So if you recall, in our last lecture only, sorry, in this lecture only, I told you which is maximum, guys, among all of these. So here we are having n power root n, right? Here we are having 2 power root n. Okay. Yes. So if you recall, I discussed these top, this thing, right? So always n factorial will be the maximum, guys, among anything. The main reason why, because, so if you are doing, okay, so if you are doing a factorial of, okay, so if you are doing a factorial of 100, so you are going to do 100 into 99 into 98 into 97 into 96 in this way, right? So it will decrease 1111. So basically your result will be too high, guys. So I did only for few values, right? So check the result. So that is the reason why n factorial will always be the maximum, guys. Got it? Yes. So for these two, you can take some examples. Okay. So let us take, what shall we take, guys? So here we are having under root, right? So what shall we take? Let us take 64. What do you say? Okay. So let us take 64. Okay. So let us substitute the values in this. So 3 into 64 root 64. Similarly, 2 into root 64 log base 2 64, right? Yes. Okay, so let us calculate using calci. So 64 power root 64, so what is the value? It is somewhat 2.81 into 10 power 4, right? So 2.81 into 10 power 4 into 3. So let us not calculate, so let us keep it like that only for now. The next one is a 2 power, okay, so I think we need to calculate this first. Okay, so log base 2 64, right? Yes. So what is the value? That is a 6. So 6 into root 6. Okay, so what is a root 6, guys? So root 64 is nothing but 8. So 8 into 6, okay, so 48, right? Yes. Okay, so 2 power 48. Okay, so I think we got the same value, right? So 2 power 48 is also 2.81 into 10 power 4. Okay, so now if you observe carefully, it is nothing but a constant, right? Yes. So with the help of constant, you cannot say which is maximum, right? So basically, whenever you are doing solving these asymptotic notations, just give me a second. Okay, so whenever you are solving these asymptotic notations, you will always avoid this constant, guys. You will assume that there are no constants. Okay, yes. So that is the reason why these two are equal, guys. So indirectly, f of n is equals to g of n, and the next greater value is h of n. Okay, so this is the logic, you can say. So now let us compare the options. The first option says that whoever is having big O, they are maximum, right? So the first option says that f of n is max, is greater than g of n. So is f of n greater than g of n, guys? No. Hence option A is wrong. Similarly, g of n is greater than h of n. That is also wrong. Yes. So the third option says that g of n is not f of n, is not big O of f of n. Okay, so even though they are equal, so if you recall, what is the condition for big O, guys? So it might be, okay, so f of n might be less than or equal to, so here we are having equal to also, right? So hence it is following the condition, hence this is false, right? Yes. Okay, so they are equal, so g of n, okay, c into g of n, right? Yes. So c into g of n should be greater than f of n, right? Yes. So here big O of g of n. So is g of n, okay, greater than f of n, greater than or equal to f of n. That's true, equal to, right? Yes. So that is the reason why D will be the correct answer. Got it? So this is a type of logical question, guys. Got it? Yes. Okay. So anyway, in our further PYQP session, we'll be discussing various questions, guys. So don't worry or don't get scared with respect to these time complexity or asymptotic notations. Okay? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea. So in the next lecture, let us understand how we can solve the recursive relation problems, okay, using Master's theorem. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.